Hello and welcome to the Isle Notre Dame once again for what promises to be another incredible Canadian Grand Prix at this fiercely competitive circuit, where pole position can often be decided by less than a tenth of a second. With top speeds of around 210 miles per hour heading into the overtaking opportunity of turn 13, the 2.7 miles of the circuit Gilles Villeneuve are some of the quickest on the Formula One calendar. There are 14 corners in total, with 60% of the lap taken at full throttle, and average speeds clock in at about 130 miles per hour. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Lando Norris put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And Oscar Piastri completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Moore, Max Verstappen, and Perez, Gasly, Magnussen, Sainz, and Alex Albon, Tsunoda, Schwartzman, Lance Stroll, and Latifi, Bottas, Ocon, George Russell and Guan Yu Zhou. Mick Schumacher and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Alongside me to discuss all the action today is Natalie Pinkham. Thanks for joining us, Natalie. And tell me, you were down in the pit lane earlier. How do you think the track conditions are today?
Well, the surface looks clean enough, but I'm a little bit worried about the track temperature. It's pretty cool out there, which could give some teams difficulties when it comes to keeping their tyres in the right operating window. The cars out there that work their tyres hard and really put a lot of energy through them, well, they'll be the ones that are better off.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Clutch bite is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap, please. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. Okay, the virtual seat. Fantastic drive, that's just fantastic, amazing, you deserve that race win, well done mate.
A truly magnificent drive and a great performance from the entire team to secure victory here in Canada. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out of the track was. Speed. It sounds like an awfully reductive statement, but fast cars win races. And we saw that today with our winner.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. We'll be right back. driver standings. Moore increases their championship lead. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
Carlos Sainz certainly wasn't someone to scoff about. His ability to follow race strategies throughout with pinpoint precision has to be commended.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car, ready for the next race weekend.